Welcome to my review of my Gothic Pikes. I purchased these when I was in Leipzig in Germany for Wave Gothic Treffen, and I got them from Wonderland 13, which I think the store's permanently closed down now, but they do have a website where they sell some pikes. So these are from the brand Boots and Braces. I got a velvet pike and it's very, very soft and smooth and very, very flexible at the top. Features a little heel here, obviously the pointed toe, and four metal buckles along the side. They're a very comfortable shoe, but that mainly comes down to the sizing, because I found when I was trying on a lot of pikes that they felt really, really tight and I just could not figure out what size I was. Normally I'm a size 39 and it still felt really tight right at the toes. And then I tried on a size 40 in this particular shoe and found that it was just right. If the toe is too squished, then it's gonna be super uncomfortable and you're gonna get blisters. So if possible, I would say go to a store if you can. If you can't, then be prepared to pay for return shipping if you try them on and find that your pikes do not fit. I tried on a lot of different pairs of pikes and this was the perfect one that actually fit. I tried on some others in size 40 and swear they still felt really tight. I love quite a few things about them. Firstly, this shoe just looks super, super simple, and the stunning silver buckles as well just really make them pop and I love them. They're very flexible and they're very comfortable to walk in. My absolute favourite Gothic boots are my New Rocks, which I did a review of here. The one downside to those is that they're very stiff at the top. They're very rigid and you can't move them around. They're not very flexible. So I really love how these are. And I did wear these for a day or two at Wave Gothic Treffen just to give my legs a break from the New Rocks a little bit, because I wanted to have more freedom to move around a bit, so I love wearing these. One downside is that it takes a little while to put them on, or longer than it would to put on New Rocks, because it's just, you know, you do the zip up and that's about it. Because when they're undone, they look like this, and then you have to wrap it around, put your foot in, and obviously match it up, find the right adjustable loop. So they do have quite a lot of options in terms of sizing. Another downside is that this buckle right at the edge here, where it connects to the bigger buckle, when I'm walking, these two will often clang together. And again, it's just a little irritating noise, particularly on one of the shoes. It's a lot louder than the other. And just every time I take a step, it's like cling, cling. If you'll be in a goth club or something dancing, you're probably not going to notice it, but if you'd meant to be going somewhere quiet, then it's just something I keep in mind. So I've worn these quite a few times. I will often just mostly wear my New Rocks because they're easier to put on and wear, but these are really lovely and they're really comfortable, and I will wear them on an alternate day at a goth festival. And I'd wanted some pikes for a long time, so I'm so glad I finally was able to stumble upon these, because I really tried on quite a lot of pairs, so sizing can be difficult when it comes to pikes. Check out my Gothic shoe review playlist. I have a whole bunch of them, and also check out my Gothic New Rock boots review. These are my favorite boots of all time, so definitely check that out. I hope this video was helpful, and thank you so much for watching.